Hey YouTube, it's the 4th of October and these are my latest gaming pickups. So the first one I've got here is Space Ace for the Atari Jaguar CD. This is the long box. Say version, it's not really a version, there's only the one version, but most copies you find only come like that, just the CD case, which is what I've already got. I've now got a copy of the long box version to add to my collection, which is good. This was a laser disc game. But now this is obviously Jaguar CD version. It's done by ReadySoft, and this was released in 1995. Next we have Dead Rising 2, the Zombrex edition for the Xbox 360. This is done by Capcom, and it comes with a steelbook case, and it's got two discs, first the game, and then you've got a DVD, Terror is Reality, the making of Dead Rising 2. This was £20.98 from HMV in Leicester, which was only £2 cheaper than the actual standard edition game, second hand. You also get this auto injector, which is basically a syringe, I don't know if you can see that, and it just doubles up as a pen, so that's quite different. And on the box it says, for the relief of light decomposition, unfamiliar cravings, increased shambling, herd instinct, terrible peeling, inconsistent pulse, rotting odours and rigor mortis. The instructions say scrub hands thoroughly with soap and hot water before opening. Disinfect injection area with alcohol rub and soapy water. Inject needle with conviction to penetrate epidermis. Administer all medication, then dispose of immediately. So that's quite nice, that one. Next we have three game.com games. For the TigerGame.com. This is a handheld console, and it was the first console to have touchscreen facility. This was released in 1997, and I'll show you the cartridge if you've never seen one before. So basically, quite a small cartridge, not too much bigger than a DS cartridge really, which is probably about that size. So that's one game.com game, and then we've got another one, Tiger Casino. It's got six winning games on here, and this was released in 1998. Last game.com game is Resident Evil 2, and this was released in 1998. I don't think you can see the screenshots there, but that's basically the zombie that turns around in the PS1 version, the animated one. There you got some weapon selections there, and basically it looks like you're about to shoot a dog there. And the next one is for the Xbox, original Xbox, and this is Oddworld Stranger's Wrath. This is rated a 12 plus and it's released by EA Games. And it's to add to my collection of the other Oddworld games that I've got for the PS1, and got another one for the Xbox. This was released in 2005. This was £3.99 from Game World in Leicester. The next ones, I got all these from Leicester Market. It was £3 for £5. I bought six, but then he gave me another one in the bundle, still paying £10. So I've got two PS2 games, Thunderhawk Operation Phoenix by Core, and this was released in 2000. and I used to, well, I have got this game Thunderhawk on the Mega CD, so it's quite interesting to see what this is going to play like as an updated version of that Thunderhawk. And we've got Pitfall, The Lost Expedition by Activision, and this is rated 3+. It's a one player game, and it also has a bonus which includes Pitfall and Pitfall 2. Next one I was quite interested in, it's called Jaguar. It's released by THQ, rated 11+, and Edge magazine, who are quite hard to please when it comes to game reviews, I think, have said beautiful. So I'm quite looking forward to seeing how this plays. This was released in 2003. Next is Bloodwake, and this is by Microsoft. This is 11+, and this was released in 2002, and basically boasting about the water effects. Don't know if you see, so I'm quite interested to see how the water handling physics are in this one. I've never seen this one before, so it's quite interesting to see this. Next is Doom 3 for the Xbox, and this is rated 18, released by ID, and it was released in 2005. I've only played Doom, the original Doom. I've never played Doom 3. I don't think I've even played Doom 2, so yeah, looking forward to playing that one as well. Next is Dino Crisis 3. I've played the original Dino Crisis on the PS1, and I did enjoy that, the Resident Evil kind of feel to it. This has obviously got better graphics than the PS1, so looking forward to that one as well. That was published by Capcom. And the last one for today is by Sega for the Xbox, age rated 11+. And it's called Gun Valkyrie. This was released in, let's see if I can find it, 2002. Infogrames is on there, so the publisher or developer, either one, Sega. And it's like a shooter kind of game by the looks of it. And so they're my pickups for October the 4th. The game playing in the background is Subterranea for the Mega Drive. I think the Mega Drive game playing actually has quite a nice animated intro, so if I just plug the controller in to show that for you. Move the games out of the way.